In this video, we have two goals. One is to explain how clearance affects half-life, and the other is to be able to propose structural changes to molecules in order to be able to control clearance so that we can control half-life. In the previous video, we saw how changing volume and distribution can affect half-life. You can do the same thing with clearance. Now, as we know, the ideal half-life for an oral once per day drug, one dose per day drug, is minimally 4 hours, but most people mention 8 hours as the goal. Now, as we think about changing clearance to affect half-life, as we increase clearance, we will decrease half-life. Similarly, if we decrease clearance, we will increase half-life. So, how do we affect clearance? Well, normally, when you talk about changing clearance, you're talking about making changes to the metabolic reactions of a molecule. So we're not going to change renal clearance. We're going to affect hepatic clearance. When you make a drug resistant to metabolism, sometimes you call this a hardening a molecule. Hardening a molecule requires identification and modification of the drug's soft spots. So by removing the metabolic soft spots in a molecule, we harden the molecule, and therefore we will decrease clearance. And normally this is the problem. We want to decrease clearance so we can get half-life up to at least 8 hours. Let's see two examples of changing clearance. In one case here, we have a drug that has a methyl group on the nitrogen. Methyl groups are very readily dealkylated through phase one oxidative reactions. If you make that methyl group more hindered, like to an isopropyl group, that will slow down this phase one oxidation reaction and will increase or decrease the clearance, increase half-life. In the second example, we're actually focusing on a phase two reaction, the glucuronidation of carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids tend to rapidly undergo glucuronidation, replacing the carboxylic acid with a sulfonic acid will tend to lead to slower conjugations of the OH group. Slower glucuronidation, a lower rate of clearance leads to extended half-life. In addition to increasing half-life, reducing hepatic clearance, and that's what all these reactions are about, reducing hepatic clearance, this has an additional benefit of increasing bioavailability. So as we reduce our clearance, specifically hepatic clearance, we are going to increase bioavailability because we will be suppressing the first pass effect, the hepatic first pass effect. Not only may the drug be dosed less frequently, but the size of the dose may also be reduced. Making structural changes to molecules must be done carefully. There's also a risk that you're going to affect the potency and efficacy. So when you make these changes, you have to monitor not just the pharmacokinetics of your molecule, but also the pharmacodynamics and even toxicity. So clearance is one of our key pharmacokinetic parameters. And by changing the structure of our molecule, we can change clearance and have an immediate impact on the half-life of our molecule and hopefully optimize the properties of our molecule.